Neutralizing agent worked. golems were supposedly only designed for heavy lifting jobs around the tower. Somebody's obviously repurposed this one for war. I always wondered what would happen if these giants went rogue. Didn't think I'd find out the hard way.
Strangest thing. Some of the bodies that I put into the fumium tanks a while ago are now showing signs of life. They've lost hair, their tissue went through a very intriguing transformation, filling their wounds and scars with fumium lesions, effectively closing the cuts. It's fascinating to see that fumium can create another life form on its own, even without any interference. One of them even woke up and smashed the glass tank. Fortunately, two remade guardians crushed it with their hammers before it could escape. If it had ever gotten into the complex, the guardians would have had no chance to neutralize it, seeing how fast and agile it was.
Oh my god, what was that?
How do you like my little minions? They serve me well. And you will too very soon.
Laura? I recognize your voice, but how can I hear you? How are you doing this? What have you become?
You're so pathetic!
The Unity Shield. I remember Runcroft complained about nested prefabs when we were trying out the shield. God knows what the old tinkerer really meant. Only he could understand himself. Sometimes. I need a key. getting so distant from each other. She takes no heed to my authority anymore. She initiates research projects behind my back, pressures her research team members, who in turn stop sticking to the safety protocols, and the accidents happen. Two operators have already died this month. One of them took a fumium jolt right through his body, and the other one... God, what was left of her I can only describe as a wet meatloaf. As if something scrambled her into hash. Her notes were full of crazy things. Something about teleportation, the merging of realities. I had to report the accidents to the Bureau. I can't understand how Laura could have changed so much. And so, Sophie, she just follows her wherever she goes, in silence. I see no joy, curiosity, or excitement in her face. I see fear. Sophie confides in me, but she sees me more as her peer, rather than as a father. Is my family really crumbling? How did it even happen? Is it my fault?